Hi everybody, I thought I'd just show you my newest acquisition. I was very, very fortunate to have found it. It's a Moline organ made sometime between 1888 and 1895. It's one of the most beautiful small chapel organs I think I've ever seen in my life. It does not really have that many tonal possibilities in it, but yet it sure can make great music. And let's take a look at the case. Well, the case is all in gorgeous original condition. It's never been refinished. It's hard to imagine how something like that could have survived that many years in such good shape. Let's get up and take even a closer look at some of the workmanship. Can you imagine what it must have taken to even do that music rack? It's just beautiful. Look at the tops. Sure sign of a chapel organ. The back of the organ has a fretwork opening to let the sound out. There's the name Moline. And the stops read straight across, if I can get this here. We've got the bass coupler, diapason, echo horn, sub bass, viola, forte, and then Vox Humana, flute, celeste, dulcet, melodia, treble coupler. So it's just about as basic as you could expect from a small organ, and yet it's very responsive and it's extremely musical. Look at the very, very nice pedals to it. It has two sets of reeds, complete sets, one 8-foot rank, one 4-foot rank, then a partial Vox Celeste, and a sub-bass. The sub-bass is quite a very, very good sub-bass. In the back of the organ, this piece of wood opens up, so you can let even more sound out of the organ. So, I'm rather excited about this. I'll try to play you something right now. Even though the organ is in unrestored condition, and a lot of reeds won't talk because they need to be cleaned, it's still capable of making music. So here, we'll give it a try.